This is a statement from the CBA 9 Youth Conference, and I'm going to read it, and I hope we get to get some lessons from it and some recommendations. And I go. We, the participants of the Youth Conference on Community-Based Adaptation, working under the theme, Youth as a Catalyst for Enhancing Effective Community-Based Adaptation, having deliberated on various sub-themes in the conference, wish to do the following things. First, we want to thank the government of the people of the Republic of Kenya for hosting the Youth Conference on Community-Based Adaptation and for their hospitality and warm welcome. We commend the Ministry of Environment, Water and Natural Resources of the Republic of Kenya for officially opening our conference and expressing satisfaction with the fact that young people are being incorporated into climate change negotiation processes. We are grateful also for all the partners that we had who came in partnering with us to make it a success. We also wish to recognize that climate change not only presents huge challenges, but as well presents opportunities for young people, which come in through technological innovation and green jobs. We wish to note that the UNFCCC COP21, that will be held in December 2015 in France, Paris, we toward that acknowledge that the activities of the UN and intergovernmental organizations addressing global climate challenge are supposed to incorporate our efforts as young people as well. We acknowledge the value of intellectual and practical contributions by policymakers and technical experts in community-based adaptation. Now, informed by the following challenges that climate change poses on the macro and micro economies of our countries, and opportunities and challenges faced by both youth organizations involved in CBA, including resource constraints, limited capacity, and inadequate space for youth representation in policy and decision-making processes, inadequate institutional mechanisms for youth engagement, and inadequate technological support in terms of innovation for young people, we chose to consider that the success of youth engagement in enhancing adaptation actions to climate change in several countries, the need of scaling out and up success stories, such as the due collection technology developed by a young person in Benin and presented at the youth conference that we had, and the commitment of youth organizations to significantly contribute to building climate resilience communities by strengthening rural entrepreneurships and to share experiences. And based on all those, the challenges and the considerations, this is what we resolve as young people to do. That we also, as we present this, I wish we take note because it's really important for us. It's from our hearts, I mean. We have Youth CBA at every upcoming CBA conferences. We get to present the outcomes of these forums to our governments, communities, private sector, and other stakeholders, and at upcoming national and regional climate change and environmental consultation meetings. We are taking this to all the meetings. It does not stop here. Hold follow-up meetings with youth organizations involved in CBA to build youth national alliances on CBA. It's not a one-off thing, it's a process. And that is what we are setting out to do as young people. Have youth representatives engaging meaningfully and supported as government delegations to all conference of parties and other regional negotiation platforms on climate change. We are asking for space, and we are getting the space, I trust. To realize the stated resolutions, we the youth seek that the Youth CBA conference be convened parallel to the main CBA, but have a day designated during the main conference for youth affairs. We had parallel processes, we didn't have time to come over this other side as young people, and this is what we say, that we need to come and engage with you as well. Additional resources be mobilized for youth-led CBA initiatives and mechanisms be reviewed to increase access to already available financial resources. For instance, establish the Youth Climate Fund. And I mean, we have young people who are engaging in CBA, but the issue is the ease to access financial resources. So how do we go about this? How do we review our mechanisms to get to see to it that young people who are undertaking practical solutions on the ground are able to get the support that they require? Our capacity in CBA be enhanced through training, mentorship, programs, and mainstreaming climate change and environmental education in national education curriculum. And promote proactive, youth-sensitive, multi-stakeholder planning. I know in our planning session for CBA, maybe it's multi-stakeholder, but our space, we were informed yesterday in a presentation that there was a presentation for an African delegation. They were talking about young people, but there was no young people in our meeting. So I wish to be informed, or I seek to for justification of that. How do you discuss young people and we are not there? So we need that space, all right? Yeah. And last but not least, we seek that participatory youth-inclusive approaches be used to develop effective community-based climate information systems, technologies, and innovations. And in this, we promise as young people that we can play a key role in technology transfer. We have so much technology in our institutions, but we have a gap between institutions and the community. So how do we come in as young people to transfer technology? Thank you very much.